Hello and welcome back to this episode of Dark Souls with me, Cheesy. And we're going to start this off the way that we started the last episode. This time I'm going to kill this son of a bitch! And it's going to be in the first attempt. No editing, look at how that my face. Also, no Sunkreed Legs Fury Sword. I've upgraded this to plus 5. Because screw this guy. He says as he gets smacked in the face. Come on, come on. That's not what I wanted you to do. Well, apparently it doesn't get any easier depending on how I do this or not. But I have a weapon that smacks the bugger for relatively decent damage. It'd be doing a hell of a lot more if I had humanity, because it's a chaos class weapon. Chaos scales off humanity up to a maximum cap of 10 humanity. After that, it doesn't add anything. But only the fire damage on it scales, so I'd still be doing more damage. Oop. That's a bit too close. No, you don't. Give me your tail! Give me that tail! Give me that booty! Screw you, Guardian! Aha! Are you even trying? This feels a bit unfair. Stop shooting lightning at me, you pansy, and get down here! Oh my freaking god! What the hell is this? Thank Christ for that! I needed to jog! That little son of a bitch. That's why the whole point of that move is you're supposed to dodge it via running. But if it's the big one, it requires a full stamina to dodge that bugger. This is so unfair! Stop hitting me with the lightning! I have never, ever, in all of my attempts of doing this, of all my playthroughs, ever seen him use that much lightning. That was balderdash. And in case you think that I've increased my health, I think I have leveled up a few times, but I'm also wearing the Ring of Faith and Protection, because I'm not going to take it off now. Screw you, kitty! That's what I expect him to do. Yeah, buckaroo. Please stop sending lightning at me. I'll be good. Ooh, power attack's definitely better. No, give me the tail. Whoa, I don't recall that attack at all. I swear to God, if he just does it again. Come on, do it. Oh. Uh-oh. No, no. Don't you dare just shoot lightning at me again. You're just being an ass! Come on. Come on. Go on. I'll circle. I'll do what you do. Don't you dare Yes, give me your tail. Give it to me! God damn it, kitty! No. Come on, charge me. I just healed. Yes! Give me the tail! God damn it! Just give me the tail! It's not even though it's pretty anyway, and you're gonna die as it stands, so it doesn't matter. Just give me the tail. Oh, I'm in a corner. Okay, screw this, I'm healing. Chug! Chug! Give me the tail! Yes! I have his tail! Screw you, kitty! Ow, lightning. Oh, I ran too close. Screw you, kitty! Aha! I get the healing! And you disorientated yourself. Oh, I scuffed that. No! 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 Bad kitty! Stop it! If I heal, he'll charge me. I'll probably then die, so that's probably not the best plan. Okay, he didn't two hit. Will the cat die? Yes! It will! It's sodding dead! Yes! I feel so good right now. The cat's dead. Let's see what its soul has to say. Also, its soul is legitimately useless. I can't forge anything with it. Its only purpose is to be used for souls. So I will do that in just a moment once I get out of here. Lucille Sanctuary. One item to be found in here, and it should be... Yep, there it is. Humanity! Have a quick read of the soul, and then we shall move on. So, the white-winged lion sanctuary watchkeeper who dreaded the spread of the abyss. The guardian exhibited traits of several animals other than lions, suggesting that this was no ordinary beast, but rather close to the beings known as demons. So, we'll just use it. Because, again, it does nothing else apart from be consumed. Ugh, this is fun. Nope, alright, repair. Do what you like. Having a purely fire-based attack is great, right? I can level up twice now. Yeah, that's great. I'll put one into dexterity, one into vitality. Then we shall go and have a chat with this lady. Hello, mushroom.
Well, look at this one. From what faraway age hast thou come? Thy scent is very human indeed, but not intolerable. Ah, Princess Dusk's savior. Thine aura is precisely as she described. I thank thee deeply for rescuing her highness, but Princess Dusk is here no longer, snatched away by that horrifying primeval human. And so I must ask, couldst thou once more play the savior? Thank you.
Everything's just been made plain to me.
I am Elizabeth, guardian of this sanctuary.
Remember what Quilana said.
Something of a godmother to Princess Dusk. I shall assist thee to my utmost, for I am one with the sorceries of Ulasil.
So basically, you can buy the same stuff you could buy from What's Her Face. Often the pear powder and that.
Thou shalt see further on. An abyss was begat of the ancient beast, and threatens to swallow the whole of Ulasil. Knight Artorius came to stop this, but such a hero has nary a murmur of dark. Without doubt, he will be swallowed by the abyss, overcome by its utter blackness. Indeed, the abyss may be unstoppable. Still, I have faith.
Yep. Who can save her?
Thou shalt see.
Okay, it's the same shindig.
May the flame.
Out of pure interest, then, since she already mentioned him, what happens if I do this?
Struggling. If there's anything I can do. Thou shalt see and not indeed
nope.
Still.
Don't say anything about me wearing the ring of that same man. Odd. So yes, as you said, further on we shall find Knight Artorias. We haven't encountered him yet. He is present, in a sense, in the main game. Also, the DLC is obviously not required in order to complete the game, but lore-wise it's very heavy, and it also contains my favourite NPC, so we're doing it. There, including that boss we just killed, there are one, two, three more? Three more bosses to be found here. So, I mean, potentially, I will finish this all in one sitting. Almost certainly not. So sort of one boss would be almost a bonus one, so to speak. So, do these things remind you of anything? Sort of, only in a vague sense, but do remind you of something, I would like to think. Oh, I ran out of stamina. First time I came here, like ever, on any game, on any of my games playing this. Ow. I attacked one of these guys, and I was fairly high level. I was in, like, almost completed, as in, I could have completed the game at the level I was at. And this guy two-shotted me. Where I was wearing armor and everything. I'd literally just been invaded as well, which was obviously very fun. But what you also get here is some very rare stuff. Stuff that there's, it's basically the slabs. You can get the various types of one of each slab apart from red in this. Because red is apparently supposed to be just overpowered or something. Because for some reason in the base game and this, including the DLC, you can get a total of one red titanite slab. And that's it. Per game. It's possible to gain another one, but the number of souls required in order to do it is actually ridiculous. It's in, like, almost wasteful quantities. Because in order to do it, it involves trading. What do you have to trade? See my pyromancy flame? How much that's cost? That needs to be plus 15 and then ascended. You can then trade that ascended flame for a red titanite slab, which is quite frankly ridiculous. Come on, get wrecked. Fire really does not seem to be doing much to this guy. Oh god, where'd the other one come from? Oh god, there's another one of those guys. I'm gonna heal just in case he tried to use his jump attack, but I am not gonna have enough Estus to do this. In this, Dark Souls. In Dark Souls 2, there's more ways to do it. Ow. I'm gonna have to kindle that bonfire. I cannot time these at all. So yeah, I'm going to have to kindle that bonfire just for some more hell. But the only reason I'll kill those guys again rather than just avoid them now is because you saw those three, and then there was another thing. Oh, for God's sake. I forgot. I'm going to do this. I had one humanity on me, but that doesn't matter when I need to in order to do this. So yeah. What you saw was like three sort of standing around doing nothing. And there's a little pond. In that little pond is a chest. And I think there's a white titanite slab? I mean, don't get me wrong, I don't need them, but it's more about just showing. So actually what we'll probably do is I'll pop back there and you'll see me again. Either if I die like a bitch trying to get it, or if I get the slab, so see you guys back there. Yay! That's actually rather well hidden, but it's there, and it's not a mimic, so open up and we obtain the blue titanite slab. Okay, so this is for sorcerers. This is actually a fairly easy
very quick one to obtain. Getting a actually it's probably quicker and easier to obtain that one than the other one you get in the game. Purely because, well, you have to make your way through an area that is majority of the enemies in it are resistant to fire. That was not what I intended to do at all. Have a quick chug. This is where things get fun. Power of fire compels you. Run away, there's too many of them. But I have a great chaos fireball. Come and get me. Oh god. I always forget they have reinforcements. Just die, please. No. Bad farmer dudes. But I hope you can see what sort of thing they become. Because as it said, what far off age are we from? So, one of two things. We are either in the future or in the past. It can only be the past because of what we were told by Dusk of Ulysses. And the fact that she has vanished from the present. Either way, we are in the past. That much is certain. So, that means that you can actually deduce where Ulysseal lies because of that which you fight and similarities. So, what are we fighting? We're fighting some weird looking dudes that look sort of half like they're made of the woodland, and some big dudes in some big stone dudes in stone armor. And the farmer dudes that look as though they're made of vegetation, they have, or they've been dropping mosses. And yeah, this legitimately freaked me the fuck out the first time. You used to be able to kill this guy at this point. Off you fly, Calamite the Black Dragon. That place is also somewhere we've been before. I must be careful, because that noise indicates a guardian nearby. That is also not what we're after. We are after this guy! Hello, friend. No, don't! I wish to be friendly. Please don't leave. Thank you, Crystal Lizard Friend. Ah, such fun. Now, notice the sounds of thunder and the like. This stuff, whatever it is. This is the abyss. Whether this chasm leads down to it is another matter, but this is the dark that's spreading. It's that that's worrying me. It's that that's worried Elizabeth, the giant mushroom. Oh, hello, he did follow me down. Sure if he did. I don't think these guys are for the most part stupid enough. Oh, they are. I'd say they're not quite stupid enough to fall off, but they will if they're starting a tracking move. Now, this bit you'll have to be slightly careful of. Jump! Ooh. A few other more clench moments like that. I heard something. There you are. Get over here. Die like a plant. Yes, I know I'm not using much pyromancy. But I'm using fire, does that count? So yeah, what is this place? Ah. Now you see. We are in the shadow of Anor Londo, at least, so we are potentially in an area that we've travelled to before. A place we haven't travelled to yet. But we might be on like the other side of where everything's occurring, so I kind of assumed to start with that we're just in another area overlooking sort of thing. Another Titanite. No, it's a corpse. It's fine. This is a corpse as well. So we're slowly getting the Guardian's stuff. I wonder if I can drag this guy off a cliff as well. Actually, you know what? I'm not going to risk it. Let's just fireball this guy. Get some combustions in. You happy now? You're getting your dose of pyromancy. You feel satisfied? He died to fire, so that counts. Ooh, twinkling titanite. Get some nice drops off these guys, but there's far better ways to farm the stuff. Another corpse. Goth's great arrows. Huh. Great arrow used by Hawkeye Goth, one of Lord Gwyn's four knights for dragon slaying. Requires great bow. Goth personally crafts each stone tip and wraps the shaft tightly with tree bark. Stone. It's made out of stone. And yes, we have heard mention of Goth before. Ugh, pardon me. No, whatever. Shot from Goth's great bow. So, as I think I actually mentioned it before, Goth is my favourite NPC. I just think he's awesome. And he's also a... You see him fight once. Well, I say fight. It's excessively one-sided, and it's glorious to watch him do it. You get sort of a scale of what the hell he's capable of. Which is just sort of... He's claiming he's no longer in his heyday, and this is his sort of... What's his... He doesn't specifically say this, but sort of autumn years. And then he pulls out that crazy stunt that he does, and you're just like, what the hell did you used to be like? Elizabeth mushrooms are effectively they're very overpowered. I don't think I've ever used one, because I'm always of the opinion of, oh, it's too rare, I'll save it for later, so I'll never use it. Should have gone down. Elizabeth mushrooms. Greatly stores HP for a limited duration. Flesh and greatly stores HP for a limited duration. Yeah, it is pretty damn powerful, I will admit. I don't need to jump to get back. Sort of slide off. And I can't get up there yet. So onwards. We have these lovely plants, which we've seen somewhere before. Now, come on, they're basically you're supposed to be able to figure this out with relative ease, where Ulusil used to be. Because obviously it's not there anymore, and you've seen a few runes around the place that indicates that they are not there anymore. Therefore implying that this is the end of it. This is it at the end, or something else happens to it. That won't be about the bushes. This is legitimately just like it's screwed. I mean, for God's sake, you're wandering around and there's bloody huge chasms everywhere. This is the end. This is not. It does not come back from this. This is a cataclysm. This is the sort of stuff that ends civilizations. So, I've only used five so far. You know, these guys are all sort of happily doing up the trees. As you can probably guess, first time I came through here, I died because I went, they'll probably aggro on me if I get that item. But it's going to be worth! Got the item and died. So instead, I'll just kill one of them to start with, make my life easier. Got another one. Take a great fireball and get the last one. Get over here! For God's sake, why does AI have to spasm out? Screw you! Screw you! Behold, Ulusil. One gold coin. Under us. Some sort of arena. Down there, see straight ahead. Got that little bit that goes down and stairs down to the left. At the top of that bit, there's a bonfire. That's the next bonfire we reach. Oh god, I forgot about this. This is painful. After everything you've endured, you've got to fight two of these buggers. Oh god, this could be a bad move. Especially when it obscures my vision. That guy's dead. Because he can die. That guy I'm gonna hit, because I can hit him. Oh god. That was excessively close. I am not quite sure how I'm still alive. Whoop. Oh god. You can see by the way it flamed up, I was attempting to use an attack there. That one to be precise. Oh, I almost made that look easy. I feel great. Right. Which is best for first one. Okay, so you have a look around. I don't think you can see anything in there. But You can debate why it's spread up there, not down below. I think you do technically get an answer. Do you get an answer? Yes. You see down there, that's obviously where we end up going. But now, get a lift. And there's obviously the boss. Now we get our second NPC. But we'll chat to him in a second. First things first, because I don't want to risk anything with taking the shortcut back up. And we're also going to grab... Oh, I forgot to grab that item, didn't I? I think that's all the Guardian equipment. Let's see. Armor. This is just at the bottom. Helmet. Did I just see that? Yeah, gauntlets and legs. Okay, that's fine. Found it all. So, for now, since we just unlocked a shortcut, I'm going to head back to the bonfire, replenish everything, repair stuff, and we'll see you back down at that NPC. See you back down at Marvelous Chester. Welcome back, and let's have a chat with this man.
Let me guess. Snatched by a shadowy limb and dragged off to the past?
Be quite correct, good
yes,
sir.
Yes, of course.
God, he's tall.
Exactly what happened to me. We are both strangers in this strange land. But at least now there are two of us. Did you happen across Knight Artorias? The legendary Abyss Walker from the old tales?
Yep.
Well, if you haven't, it's just as well. He's a colorless sort, if you ask me.
Wow.
So, what did that giant mushroom make you do? Not that I care. It's none of my business.
Why the hell would you ask? This guy's just weird.
I've little to talk. Oh, you know me. What?
Oh, well. What's he got to offer? Green blossoms. They're nice, but they cost more than on the other merchant you can get them for. Magic, all this talisman, all this good shindig. It's plenty of bolts. Yeah, he sells some pretty decent stuff. Pretty sure he sells it all at overpriced, but I need a few of these. Actually, how many can I buy? That seems a tad excessive. Let's just go for 9, round it up to 10.
So long.
So long, good sir. It was pleasant talking to you. Now, this boss is definitely one of the harder ones. Potentially, I'll just get wrecked by him. Potentially, I'll make him look half easy. Because I've done him enough times. I actually actively avoided him after beating the first times. Like, the next few games only won because I had to, but... Then I got indulged in them. I did that in the first one. Just to play this sort of thing and just do it for the gameplay, I kind of feel like you're only giving the game half its glory. Probably a bit excessive, but... Its lore is good, because it doesn't just spoon-feed you it. As I said before. I like the way they do it. Knight Artorias the Abyss Walker, overcome by the abyss from which he walked through. Bring it, asshole. Ooh, that toss. God, he's as good at dodging as I am. That's an insult to him, to be quite frank. I suck at dodging. Oh god, that's too early. And he didn't break my poise? Is that because I'm wearing his ring? Don't kill me, please. I said please. Oh, I did not make that look easy at all. Well, crud. Knight Artorias. Right then, here we go, round 2. I did swap out of rings, I don't have Artorias to swing on, I've got increased physical damage. Bring it on, Artorias. I wanted my souls back, so sue me. Well, that dodge went well. So did that one. I wasn't even up yet. Well, this is going just as well as last time. Well, that went even better than last time. As I said, either I'll just get wrecked or I'll make it look easy. Right. Should be right back. I'm going to try the Ayaton this time, though. Right then, attempt number 3, and due to weight requirements, I'm going to swap that out for that. Let's see how this does. Hang on, Artorias. Ooh, I thought that was too early. Okay, that's not done. Ow! I did not expect that. Come on, man. And faded you and your crazy ass grace. Ow! God, my reaction speed is slow as all balls. Well, just too early. So, what other boss does that? What other boss is a two-hitter? Ow. Let me heal. No! Ow, that didn't work. This isn't gonna work. Ooh, I just got the chug in. Right, that should do for now. Christ, I'm doing awfully. I used to be good at this. And look at that, he freaking dodges that. I miss strength weapons. Actually, that's a thought. I'm actually capable of using one of the ones that I was very disappointed I got at the start. I can use the Black Knight Greatsword, I just have to two-hand it. Oh, I didn't expect a follow-up. I'm actually going to give that a shot. So, going on to number 4. Such fun! Such fun. Right then. The thing is, attempt number 4, we're not wearing gloves, so I can still fast forward, and I just knocked my mic. Apologies for that. So let's try this again, Artorias the Abyss Walker. Oh, that feels so good. That did not feel so good. Oh. Look at that sludge just lobbing everywhere. Ooh, that was close. No! Stop! Come on, Artorias. Ow, pain. Don't you dare. No, you don't. You don't get to buff yourself. However, I get to die. No! I dodged the wrong way. Oh, well. You saw he sort of... You heard him start to yell. That's basically... He does something which he sort of powers himself up and then explodes outwards. And then he keeps that power, so he just becomes more powerful. So stopping it is a good plan. Also, he gets a free hit, so yeah. We'll roll with this weapon for now, but I will switch back to it just after this boss, because he's just... He's... a difficult boss because you have to be very consistent with him. As I said before, I know what I'm doing with this game, I don't even good at it. I'm not that good. And to be honest, I just like my strength weapons. I really do, it just makes life easier. Like, why'd you hit it 5 times and you can do the same in 2 hits? And that was supposed to be a jump attack. Oh well. Anyway, see you back at the boss. Here we go again. Come on then, Artorias the Abyss Walker. I keep saying that. I should really come up with something different to say when I first come in here. I want my humanity back. Get wrecked. I'm fine taking that because it's by far his weakest attack. Because every other attack is get smacked by the greatsword. Which is not something I like doing. That's it, I swear to God, if you're just going to do that now, I'm not going to be happy. Whoop. Oh God. Damn it. See you guys back. Come on. I suck at this game now. Onwards to the next attempt. Oh god, this is the way back. Well, good start. Good start. So that's how he does that attack. Ooh, I'm on form now. Yeah, just yell at me. That's definitely the best way to not get slapped. Follow-ups are always good though. Get back here, Artorias. I'm not letting you buff yourself. You do enough damage as it is. Oh god, I screwed that up, that timing so badly. The usual thing is, don't panic. I try and practice what I preach. But for the most part, you never want to just panic heal. You want to dodge an attack, then heal. So treat it, basically, what you do is you heal instead of attacking. It's the best way to do it. There was a very, very bad time to heal. As I said, you want to do it in the period in which you would attack. Like here, I'd attack. Instead, I shall heal. Come on, the Artorias. Fortunately, I did not have the reach for that. God, he's as bad as dodging as I am. Heal instead of attack. Get smacked in the face. Don't get smacked in the face and heal. All that's happening now is I'm healing. This does not bode well for the rest of the fight. Ah, right. Also, this is one of those underrated tunes in this game. I like it, but it's not one I'd go off and listen to on my own. I should really be backstepping that. Well, not backstepping it, but he's gonna buff again. The evidence two rolls away, that's a back. That's a. Oh, what are you doing, Artorias? You're running at me. Stop making me scared! No! I would have hit there anyway, so I'll take that hit. God damn it, you're not allowed to suddenly get good. That's my job. Heck, I barely even got anywhere before. Oh, yeah, that's a mistake. This won't be. Ah! Oh, this is looking good. I really should not have said that, should I? An idiot would try to finish him with pyromancy. Thankfully, I am an idiot! That was not what I meant to do! No, Artorias! No! It's what I get for being stupid! Oh, if I hadn't switched pyromancy, that would be it. You guys get to laugh at me for trying to be a show-off. Right, back we go. Once more, into the breach! Into the breach once more, you dogs. Right, let's not fuck around this time, Artorias. Oh, that was a great start. Ow, please let me up. Please, unmerciful Artorias. I mean you no harm, I just wish to kill you. I was a bit late to be healing. Should have already healed. Oh well. I'm fine with that. Too early. No, that's a follow up. That's the third one. And that's a heal. Dodge. Ah, extra attack. Ooh, two hits. That's glorious. He's gonna heal. Not heal. Buff himself, hit twice. Knock, break his poise, and then get the hell out. Get hit in. It's fine. Oh, my A game's on. Oh god. He says he gets double whammied. Oh, not on the A game anymore, bitch! Fine. Freaking leap the hell away, Artorias. If I care. That's why he was at the start. Back we go. Into the next one. Not quite sure what the point of that one is. Ah, screw you, Artorias. Just screw you. Comes a point where you stop caring about someone's past and just want to murder them! Ow. Oh, okay, for that of it. That is about right. Okay. Nope. It's a two hitter. Not quite. This is a three hit combo. Nope. Okay. Too early. Should have already healed. Heal. Chug! Double chug! Yes! Chug! Chug! I want to live, or more specifically, kill him. That's a leaping attack. Or not. God, I hate the fact this boss dodges. Not getting that hit in. I'm getting this one. I'd say he's probably about that point. Okay, that was fun. Ow. Do expect a bit more warning for that one. I'm gonna chug instead of hitting. Because I wish to live! But this is definitely one of the harder bosses. It's just... it's one of those ones where I feel like... it's the same in Bloodborne, and it's the same in a sense in Dark Souls 2. Whereby they seem to make the game decide that, okay, this would be great. And then they put in DLC bosses which are normally actually better or harder. It's generally people you'd rather fight. I'm going to get myself killed here. I don't think he's going to do that. Ow. I'm suddenly not doing so well. He's using attacks I don't like. See, that's one I can deal with. He's not great like that. I'd rather get hit by that one than any of the other follow-ups. That one's always have to be careful. That one hurts like all balls. This is my last Estus. Oh god. Here comes the pain train. Oh god, this could be painful if I let him. Nope! Bad Artorias. Come on then. Multiple spins? No. Oh, I failed to even dodge it. Oh. No! It can't end this way. But it can, it already has before. Yes! Oh, it feels great, but look at his soul. Check, it looks similar to the other boss souls, but soul of Knight Artorias, victim of the Abyss. Legend that Artorias repelled the Abyss only told half the story. It seems that he was defeated and his honor preserved by some unsung hero. Who is the true victor of the Abyss? That be us. So, for now, this is why our adventure in the DLC actually ends for now, because in order to get an item that's not strictly required, but it is in order to do it if on the optional boss here, I need to go down. Down into the crypts, through into the catacombs below. Next time, you get to see me kill some skeletons. So for now, just light us a wee bonfire. Sit down to rest. Do some leveling. And Master of BS. So I'll see you next time. Patty bye.